Hi, my name is Nikita Patel, and I'm a student at the University of Colorado and part of the group called Vegan Justice League. I'm going to show you one of my favorite recipes called samosas. Samosas are a traditional Indian food that are eaten throughout the year, in particular at Diwali, which is the Indian Christmas. They're also eaten at weddings. This recipe has been passed down for generations. When I was little, my mom let me chop the potatoes or just mix a few things here and there. But as I got older, she let me do other tasks such as deep frying. Now that I'm old enough, I can make the entire dish on my own and enjoy it on my own time. These are the ingredients you will use. High heat vegetable oil, which can be either soybean oil or canola oil, warm water, half a cup all-purpose flour, quarter teaspoon mustard seeds and half a cinnamon stick, 3 cloves and half a teaspoon cumin, a lime, quarter onion chopped, 2 cups frozen peas and carrots, 2 potatoes. For the potatoes, you will need half a teaspoon salt, half a teaspoon paprika, quarter teaspoon turmeric, quarter teaspoon ground cinnamon, and a quarter teaspoon ground cumin. For the frozen peas and carrots, you will use half a teaspoon salt, half a teaspoon paprika, quarter teaspoon ground cinnamon, and a quarter teaspoon ground cumin. And you will also use natural uncooked tortillas, which you can buy at Costco or any Mexican or Hispanic store. The utensils to make this are a chopping board, a slotted spoon, wooden spoon, a knife, a deep frying pan, just has to have some depth, and a medium saucepan. First, finely chop the onions and chop the potatoes into 1 centimeter cubes. Heat 3 tablespoons of oil, the mustard seeds, the cinnamon stick, and the cloves, and cover until you hear the mustard seeds starting to pop. Add the whole cumin and the chopped onions, stir and saute for 2 minutes. Add the potatoes and the potato spices, which is the one with turmeric, then cover, turn the gas to low, and cook for 5 minutes. Add the frozen peas and carrots, the spices to go along with that, 2 tablespoons of lime juice, cover, and cook for 30 minutes. Turn off heat, set aside, and let cool. The potatoes will be really well done, just as they're supposed to be, because we want the mushy bit in the inside of the samosa. Traditionally, my mom makes the samosa wrappers using flour, salt, oil and water, and she makes a dough out of it and then rolls them out. However, I use a shortcut method and I use whole wheat tortillas. We will use 10 of these tortillas and cut them into thirds. To glue the samosa wrappers together, we will make a simple homemade glue, which is all-purpose flour and some warm water. Slowly add warm water, mix, and continue this until you have a thick paste. While the potatoes are cooking and cooling, we'll make our samosa pouches. First, put one of the third pieces right in front of you. Fold the right side over to make a triangle. Using the glue, we'll stick one side of the pouch. And we'll fold this over and gently press it. Now, your pouch is ready for the filling. This bit will open and you'll add the filling inside. For the portions that are curved, the curved edge should be away from you. Our filling is now cooled, so we'll remove the cloves and the cinnamon stick. While the mixture was cooling, I stored all of our pre-made shells in a bag. Now I will fill the samosas with about 1 to 2 tablespoons of filling and then stick the extra flaps over to make a triangle. Fill the pot half full with oil. To make sure that the oil is at the correct heat, in India, we tear off a little piece of our tortilla and we stick it in the oil, and if it bubbles up and rises to the top, then it's ready. Put the samosas in the oil, frequently turn them, and cook them until all sides are golden brown. These samosas smell so good and they taste best right when they're hot at this temperature and with your favorite chutney. My favorite is peanut chutney.